Hello, this is Brian Tienhaara, Americas Generators Triton Power. This is one in many of a series of generator know-how-to or go-to videos that we will be doing to show our customers and the general public how to work on standby generators and fix common problems that you will find in the generator world. Today I'm here to discuss automatic voltage regulators with you. Specifically, how to change out your automatic voltage regulator, commonly known as an AVR. This is a condition that you would have on a generator if your AVR failed, which is generally would be manifested as seeing a low voltage or no voltage condition on your generator. In general, you will see an AVR fall on your control panel. It would be seen as a low voltage or an under voltage fall, at which time you would need to try to reset the fall, clear it, start the generator again. If the fall persists, I'm going to show you steps you would take to diagnose that the AVR is bad, at which time then you would get a new one and replace it. This time I'm going to simulate an under voltage fault on your control panel. Upon seeing this fault on your controller, the first step most people would take would be to acknowledge the fault, reset it, and then try to start it again to see if the fault is present. If the fault persists, at which time we recommend that you would get a voltage multimeter, I'm using a Fluke digital, and verify physically that it's not a control panel malfunction and that the voltage is indeed low on the output. Okay, at this time I'm going to start the generator, and I should be seeing 208 voltage on this. I'm looking for 208 volt output. I'm only seeing 160. So at this time, I'm going to check the regulator. The regulator is running at 208, or should be running at 208. It was running at 160. So I've diagnosed that the voltage is indeed low. Now I have to troubleshoot to make sure that it is the regulator that is at fault. Your generator could be set at 240, it could be set at 480. So the voltage may vary, but the condition will be the same. Prior to doing any work on the voltage regulator as far as wiring, it's important to disconnect the power source. You don't want the generator to operate while you are working on the electronics. And this generator is very simple. It has a circuit breaker that turns off the control panel, at which time the generator is safe to work on. Locating your voltage regulator on your generator is a simple process. Every generator comes with a box, a metal box that comes on top of it, commonly known in the industry as the doghouse. Your voltage regulator will be located inside this doghouse. It is commonly accessed from a panel that is located exterior of the box. So what you'll be looking for is a small panel that you can unbolt to gain access to the regulator. On this unit, the regulator is mounted here. I've already pre-loosened these bolts to make this go a little bit quicker. Your voltage regulator is a printed circuit board. Okay, now that we've located the AVR and we've removed the access panel, generally you will find a diagram behind the access panel that shows you where all the components are listed inside the unit and all the connections. At this time, what we would recommend is that you verify that all the connections on the board are tight, that nothing is vibrated loose, This is an operating piece of machinery. It operates at 1800 RPM. So it is possible something has come loose over time. So you can basically check just by using your hand, make sure the items are tight, that nothing has come loose. That's pretty much the only passive check you can do. Now we can do an operational check. Okay, at this step, we are going to be checking the voltage regulator operation. As you can see from the drawing on the back here, there's a voltage adjustment pot. This is very similar to the set button on your governor for your speed control in your automobile. This is what sets the operating voltage of your generator. Yours will come factory set to your desired output. This one we will be adjusting to verify the operation of the regulator and determine if the regulator is malfunctioning. We would recommend that only qualified generator technicians or electricians proceed with this step, as there is a live electrical circuit in here and only qualified people should be in there.